Hi friends, I'm here with a yoga offering. As always, please go at your own pace, rest whenever you need to, and feel free to skip things or change things if they're not working for you today. Let's begin on our backs. We can come into a savasana type position. Head spread out. You either close your eyes or take a soft gaze up towards the ceiling. Allow the weight of your body to settle back into the support underneath you. Slowing down. Exhale, letting go of whatever you're ready to let go of. And continuing to invite more release. Closed or open them as it's useful for you. I'm going to start by sliding arms overhead, reaching out really long through your arms and legs. Interlace your fingers, press out through your palms, flex your feet. And then bring the right knee to your chest, grab hold of it and draw it in. Check that your shoulders are dropped, the back of your neck is long. And then straighten the right leg up towards the ceiling, holding somewhere behind your leg, flex and point your foot a few times. Circle your ankle a couple times, both directions. And bend your knee in and open it out to the right. You can straighten part way or all the way out to the side, holding where it makes sense for you, but staying grounded through the left leg. Where is there to let go of here now? Just release, bend your knee, bring it across, spinal twist. Staying in your twist, try straightening your right leg on a low diagonal, right arm on a high diagonal, letting fingers and toes reach away from one another. And then roll back onto your back. Bring both knees in. Take a circle or rock with your knees, massaging the lower back. Sink them into the floor. And then grab hold of just the left knee. Drop the right leg long. Squeeze this knee in close. Straighten this leg up towards the ceiling. Flex and point your foot a few times. Circle your ankle a couple times, both directions. Bend your knee in, open your knee out to the left, and then straighten part way or all the way out to the side, grounding down through the back of your right leg. Release, bend your knee, bring it across, spinal twist. First with a bent knee.
try straightening the left leg on a low diagonal, left arm on a high diagonal. And roll back onto your back, bring both knees in. Take another little circle, rock, massaging the lower back and sacrum into the floor. And then rock your way up to sitting. Let's come into a comfortable cross-legged position.
If you want to sit up on something, you're welcome to grab a blanket or cushion. And we'll take the right arm up, bend it straight back on itself, grab your elbow, and take it back. As you do this, drop the rib cage, draw the belly in. Feeling around within each pose, what are you noticing on the inside? Let's release, right arm up, open it out, take it across, and then hook with the other arm. Hug it in as close as you can. As you do this, draw back through your right shoulder so you're still square across the chest. Breathing deeply. Release, arm out, rotate thumb to point down, wrap it around behind your back so back of your hand is at your waist. Interlace fingers at your waist, pull the knuckles around towards the front, elbows go towards one another, and then circle your right shoulder, just putting a little movement in a place that may be a bit creaky or tight. Keeping fingers interlaced, reach both arms back, open up the chest, and you can stay upright or fold forward. Folding might be just dropping your head, or could be coming partway or all the way to the floor. Maybe reaching arms up and back away from you. Release, come up, hands to knees, round back. Lean away from your hands on your knees, drop your chin. And roll your way up. Let's recross the leg so the other leg is in front or on top. Left arm up, bend it straight back on itself, grab your elbow, take it back. As you do this, drop the ribs, draw the belly in. Release arm up, open it out, take it across, hook with the other arm, hug it in close. As you do this, try and feel the length and spaciousness of your torso in full height. Rib cage wide and open. And then release, arm out, thumb points down, wrap it around. This time when you go to interlace your fingers, try the other thumb on top, knuckles towards the front, elbows towards one another, and then circle your left shoulder. Fingers interlaced, reach both arms back, open the chest, and then fold any amount. Release, come up, hands to knees, round back. Roll your way back up and let's bring the feet to the floor. Hip width apart, parallel. You can shift your weight forward so the hands are in front of the feet and then take a little rock front to back. You're just working with your mobility. You don't have to have more than you have. As you rock your weight forward, you are looking for a stretch through your toes. As you rock back, getting into calves, ankles, Achilles tendon. Notice your hands on the floor, fingers spread, waking up the hands, getting hands ready to receive more weight soon. And then drop your heels as you lift the hips, shifting weight back to hang in ragdoll. You can bend your knees a little or a lot. Any movement here. Maybe sway or shake out. Bend the hands near the front of the mat and step back into a high push-up position. Lower down, low push-up. Then come into your back bend. This could be as low or high as you like. Cobra or up dog. And then back to down dog when you are ready. Hips high. Want to pedal out your feet a little bit or take any other movement that helps you get into your body. Take your time. Feel what you're doing. Drop the knees and sink back to child's pose. Releasing hips to the heels, forehead to the floor. Find a relaxed position with your arms and shoulders. Arms out in front of you. Walk your hands over to the left. And then pull back through your right hip, stretching right side a little more. Come through center and over to the other side. Pull back through the left hip, stretching left side a bit more. And then back to center. Let's lift up through table. Come back through down dog. Take your right leg up. Bend your knee to your chest. And start circling this bent right knee, making the biggest circle possible for your hip joint. If you would rather do this from hands and knees, you're welcome to drop the left knee to the floor and do this from table. Next time your leg is up, reach it straight, send it a little higher, and then take a big step forward, low lunge. We're going to drop the back knee. Feel free to pad it by rolling up the side of your mat, or if you have something, blanket or cushion, feel free to use that. If you want to use blocks, and you have them, feel free to put something under your hands. Allow the hips to sink forward, looking for stretch on the front of the left hip. You may need to adjust the distance between your feet. If that front foot didn't get far enough forward, it might be a little tight on the knee and ankle, in which case, take it a bit further forward. You're welcome to keep the hands on the floor or the blocks, or bring your arms up to the front knee, your hips, or even arms up. Knees release, hands to the floor or blocks if you have them. Take the hips back for a hamstring stretch. Inch the front foot forward
And then flex the toes back. So you end up with hips right above the back knee, hands right under shoulders as high as you need them. Feel free to come way up on your blocks. And go towards hips square, towards a flat back, towards folding, towards a straight right leg, but making sure not to overstretch or hyperextend. So a little bend may be a good idea. And if any of you want to go further forward towards splits, you're also welcome to slide the front heel forward, listening to your body. Don't go beyond your limits. Slide forward, slide your way back to release. Let's bring both hands to the inside for lizard pose. Turn out through the right foot and then shift your weight forward, coming down onto the elbows, on blocks or the floor. You may want to explore shifting weight more to the left or right, scooting hips further forward or backward. You could also try adding a quad stretch by bending the back leg and reaching back for it. If that doesn't work, don't do it. Don't worry about it. Finding how this works for your body, what variation of this is interesting or useful for you. Make your way back to down dog. And you're welcome to take any movement transition. Could come through high to low push up, up dog, or cobra, back to down dog. But you're welcome to just step back or move in some other way. From down dog, when you are ready, take your left leg up, bend your knee in, and start circling this bent left knee, feeling what you are doing. If you did do this from tabletop on the other side, do so again. Next time your leg is up, reach it straight. Big step forward, low lunge. If your foot doesn't make it far enough forward, you might pick it up and bring it there, or shimmy the back knee back. Maybe grabbing blocks for your hands, padding for your back knee, finding your way. Sinking hips forward, looking for an opening at the front of the right hip. You can keep your hands down, you can bring your hands to your knee, or your hips or arms up. You did on the first side. One more breath. Release. Hands to the floor, hips back for a hamstring stretch. Inch the front foot forward, flex your toes back, finding your edge where it is. Just going in the directions you know you're going, and breathing, feeling where you are. If at any point you want to go deeper, you're welcome. You could go towards splits. If at any moment you need to back out a little bit, see if you can keep adjusting so that you maintain your edge. If it gets to be too much, back off. Something opens up, move into that space. Let's release, slide your way back. Lift it side forward. And we'll come into lizard pose. Both hands to the inside. Turn out through the left foot. And then shift your weight forward, allowing hips to release towards the floor. Taking any variations you did on the first side, if you did add a quad stretch, you might try that again. Your way back to down dog, however you get there. Let's take a couple breaths in down dog or child's pose or sitting. Sitting. Let's get set up for a supported fish. There's many ways to do this. If you know how you like to do it, come right into it. I'll talk through a couple options and you can find your way. So we do need some props for this. Block is great. If you don't have a block, you can use a rolled up yoga mat, a foam roller, firm cushion, rolled up towel, a stack of books with a blanket over it, finding something to put behind your upper back and see how it feels. Depending on how high it is, you may want something else supporting your head so that your chin isn't lifted, but instead chin dropped and back the neck long. If it feels too intense, try something smaller or softer. If it's too subtle, you might try something harder or higher. Arms can be overhead or out to the side. Legs can be bent or straight. If there's any gripping in your lower back, try tucking your tail towards your heels to lengthen that out. If there's still any gripping, you may want to do this with feet on the floor and the knees bent. Settling into pose you're in. How much you can let go here. It's a very deep back bend, but very little effort is required. If you'd like to stay here longer, that is of course an option. If you are ready to release, one gentle way of doing so is to interlace your fingers behind your head. Use your arms to lift your chin to your chest, taking the pressure off your props. Lean to one elbow and move your stuff out of your way. Take a happy baby, grab the soles of your feet, press your knees towards the floor, and this can be done in stillness, or with a little rocking. You can keep your legs bent or straighten them one at a time or together. I'm going to wind this practice down if you'd like to join me. Do whatever you need to do to feel complete in your practice. If you're enjoying what you're doing, you can stay till it's done. If you want to keep practicing on your own, that's of course an option. time you finish something, just ask, what do you feel like doing now? Is there another pose? Is there some part of your body that could use some attention? Is there some way you like to wind things down? Up. And if you would like to join me in savasana, you could do so when you're ready. Feel free to adjust your clothing or grab any props so you're more comfortable. Eventually settling into stillness. Eventually stretching out through your arms and legs. When you're ready, bring your knees in. Roll to one side. Use your hands to help you up to sitting. Bring hands together at the heart. And just take a moment to silently thank yourself for your practice. And you can let that gratitude expand out to the people and circumstances that make it possible for you to be here. Extend far and wide, maybe even sending gratitude and well wishes to all beings everywhere. Namaste. Thank you, everyone. Thanks so much for joining me. Hope you have a good rest of your day.